Those people told you for days in advance that if the university sought to go ahead with that construction, they were going to physically destroy the university.
Why did you negotiate many times?
Negotiate? What is to negotiate? What is?
The university is a public institution.
That's right. But the university,
its own community, and for the community of Berkeley that live around it.
All of it began the first time some of you who know better and are old enough to know better let young people think that they had the right to choose the laws they would obey as long as they were doing it in the name of social protest.
I'm sick and tired of the argument about whether some effort to enforce law and order is going to escalate anything at all. Plain truth of the matter is this has to stop, and it has to stop like the day before yesterday.
I would like to propose that the issue is that on the campuses, you who are adults, you who are entrusted with those young people and their guidance, have a responsibility to make it plain to them from the very beginning that you yourselves do not tolerate the kind of conduct that has led to the burning of Wheeler Hall, that has led to two murders on the campus of UCLA.
You created an atmosphere on the campus where no one wants to listen. No,
you are a liar.
I have read and I have been questioned since I've been here about certain demonstrations against my coming. And I would like to say just one thing. And to those who demonstrate so, I wonder if they have ever asked themselves that if they should have the kind of government they apparently seek, no one would ever be able to do what they're doing again.
Anything, and I have a feeling that if you check closely on some of the more militant of those leaders who are advocating violence, you'll find that if you settle whatever issue it is that has them worked up today, they'll be back tomorrow morning with another issue. But I think the time has come for them to make a choice and to decide whether they want to continue to even tolerate these false prophets in their midst who are, if anything, destroying their own community.
I don't think taking to the streets and rioting and disorder has ever solved anything or ever will.
Those who would trade our freedom for the soup kitchen of the welfare state have told us they have a utopian solution of peace without victory. They call their policy accommodation. And they say if we'll only avoid any direct confrontation with the enemy, he'll forget his evil ways and learn to love us. All who oppose them are indicted as warmongers. They say we offer simple answers to complex problems. Well, perhaps there is a simple answer. Not an easy answer, but simple. If you and I have the courage to tell our elected officials that we want our national policy based on what we know in our hearts is morally right, we cannot buy our security, our freedom from the threat of the bomb, by committing an immorality so great as saying to a billion human beings now enslaved behind the Iron Curtain, give up your dreams of freedom, because to save our own skins, we're willing to make a deal with your slave masters.
Recently, in some places in the nation, there's been a disturbing reoccurrence of bigotry and violence. If I may, from the platform of this organization, known for its tolerance, I would like to address a few remarks to those groups who still adhere to senseless racism and religious prejudice. To those individuals who persist in such hateful behavior, if I were speaking to them instead of to you, I would say to them, you are the ones who are out of step with our society. You are the ones who willfully violate the meaning of the dream that is America. And this country, because of such what it stands for, will not stand for your conduct.
There are cities in Michigan. Oh, shut up.
I'll stop a little bit. That's good. All right.